Hello friends, welcome to the next session of Data Structures and Algorithm series. Today we will see maximum sum subarray. This approach will follow order of n cube. So let's see how we will go through this question. So what do we mean by a subarray? So subarray is a continuous part of an array. So if we see the first example 4 minus 1 2 1, so subarray will contains like subarray will can have only one element like 4 minus 1 2 1, or it can have like two elements like 4 and minus 1 or minus 1 and 2 or 2 and 1. So like these are different subarrays of size 1, size 2. We can have subarray of size 3 also, something like that, 4, minus 1, and 2. So the main thing is that it should be continuous. We cannot have a subarray with the elements 0, 2, and 3, as it is not continuous, or as it is, and we will not call it as a subarray. So it should be continuous, like 0, 1, 2, or 1, 2, 3, or 0, 1, 2, 3. So this array is also a subarray only, like 4, minus 1, 2, and 1. So this is also, so the whole array will also be a subarray. So now we have to find the maximum sum. So what do we mean by maximum sum? If you sum all the elements within an subarray, and that is maximum, then it will be maximum sum subarray. So in the first example, 4 minus 1, 2 and 1. If we see single elements like 4, then 4 is maximum in the arrays of size 1. But what will be the maximum value that we can get from the subarray in this example? So it should be 4 minus 1 plus 2 plus 1. So what it will give? 4 plus 2 6, 6 plus 1 7, 7 minus 1 is 6. So the maximum value that we can get from subarray is 6. So in the next example, as you can see, if we exclude this negative element, then this subarray will give us the maximum sum subarray. So it will be like 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. What it will give? It will return 3, 3 plus 6, 6 plus 4, 10. So in this case, you are assuming that there should be some negative values. Otherwise, the maximum subarray will be the whole array. So as you can see here, all the values are positive. As all the values are positive, so all the elements will sum up and it will say maximum sum subarray will contain all the elements. So in this case, what will be the maximum sum? It will be adding all the values that are indexes at 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it will be like 10 plus 1, 11, 11 plus 20 is 30, 30 plus 5 is 35, 35 plus 7 is 42. So this value will contain 42. In this example, what will be the maximum sum subarray? So that we have to calculate. But in my view, it should be something 4. It will be 4 plus minus 2 plus 5. So the final result will be 5 plus 4, 9, 9 minus 2, 7. So 7 will be the maximum sum subarray. Or is there any other also thing? So probably this will be the answer. 7 will be the answer. So now let's see, move to the example. And now we will find like what all things will be there. So first I will index this thing 0, 1, 2, 3. So what first we will find all the subarrays. So as the length of the array is 4. So I will just define a variable as max. And next one, I will define the size. So first I will find all the subarrays that are of size 1. So what will be the, so size of subarray 1. So what will be all the arrays that will be of size 1? So 1 will be 4, 1 will be minus 2, 1 will be 5, and 1 will be minus 1. So what is maximum in all these 4 elements? The maximum is 4. So I will write just 4 and size is 1. Okay. So now I will find all the subarrays that are of size 2. So what will be the of size 2? So all the subarrays of size 2. So 4 minus 2. Another one will be minus 2, 5. 4 minus 2 will be 1. Minus 2, 5 will be 1. And 5 minus 1 will be 1. So what will be the sum of both these elements? It will be 2. What will be the sum of both these elements? It will be 3. And what will be the size of this? It will be 4. So the maximum here is what? 4. So for the size of arrays of size 2, the maximum value that we are getting is of 4. So now the next task is to find all the values or all the subarrays that are of size what? Of size 3. So now let's calculate all the subarrays that are of size 3. So first one will be 4 minus 2, 5. I will just try to remove the older. So now we are checking the size 3. So first one will be from here to here. 4 minus 2 and 5. Second one will be from here to from second elements to this element. There will be only 2 subarrays of size 3. So the next one will be what? Minus 2, 5 and minus 1. Now we will see what will be the sum of these elements. It will be 4 plus 5, 9. 9 minus 2 will be 7. And for this, it will be what? Minus 3 plus 5 is plus 2. So I will write maximum value is 7 and size is 3. And now the fourth one, how we will calculate? We will add all these elements. Like all these elements mean adding all the values of at index 0, at 1, at 2 and 3. So 4 minus 2 will be 2. 2 plus 5 is 7. 7 minus 1 will be 6. So when the size of array is 4, so the maximum value is 6. So we have to find what is the maximum sum. So it will be 7. So our answer for this problem is like where we have find the maximum values. What is the maximum sum of the subarray? Basically, it is from index 0, 1 and 2 where we have found this. 4 minus 2, 5 here. What are the indexes? 0, 1 and 2. So we have find a maximum value at index by adding the values at index 0, 1 and 2. So now we will start to see the code, how it will work. We will go to our PyCharm. So here I have already made the program. So let's now does not wait for anything and go through the example. So the value that we are going to run is these values. So now let's go to through this program. So our array will be what? 4 minus 2, 5 and minus 1. So there will be three for loops. That's why it is called order of n cube. So we will see how these for loops are working to get the maximum sum subarray. So first loop is to tell what is the size of the subarray that we are seeing. So it will go from 1 to where size plus 1. Size plus 1 is what? I will just make the indexes also clear. So this one is the 0 index. This one is 1. This one is 2. This one is 3. So 0 to 4. 1 to 4, sorry. So basically here what we are saying is saying that our array or subarray size will be ranging from 1 to 4. So what will be the like subarray of size 1 or what? Like the individual elements like 4, minus 2, 5 and minus 1. So these are the array of size 1, and array of size 2 will be what? 4, minus 2, minus 2, 5 and all the values extracted. So as you have already seen that the first for loop subarray size will iterate from 1 to 4. This is to control the size of the subarray. The second loop is starting index. Like what should be the starting index where our subarray is starting. So this start index is for checking where we are starting the subarray. And this condition is for checking that we are not going out of index. Like this is a very famous exception, index out of bound exceptions and all those things. So this is to control index out of bound. So as we move through this program, it will become more clear why we are using this function. And this is the last loop, like sum is equals to 0. This thing is to find the sum, like what should be the maximum sum we have find till now. Val is like a global variable for us, and we have initialized its value to a very highly negative value. As you have already seen, it will be 6 dot max size and the negative of that value. So it will be a very negative value like negative of infinity. So these are the things that we have already got through this. So I will just go back